What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over your control panel and how to use it to its fullest potential. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. As a server owner, having access to each piece of your server is crucial to keeping proper setup and backend configuration. Here, you can access a variety of tools and options available for your server. From monitoring the chat and console to accessing all of the server files, understanding each section of the server panel is necessary to make sure you have control over your server. Let's go over all of the ins and outs of the panel. Once you're at the login page, logging in is fairly simple. Use the username and password that you created or the ones that were sent to you in an email when you bought your server. For your security, the panel will automatically log you out if your IP address changes, but you can check the Allow IP Changes box to disable this function. Once you're logged in, you will be greeted with a nice dashboard with things like our latest guides, news, and some other useful information you can use to learn more about server hosting. Click on the green Go to My Server button at the top of the page to pull up your new servers panel and start making changes. Once you're at your server, this is your main panel page. This page is where you can change the server name, adjust the world, or alter other important settings. Along the left-hand side are a ton of other sections that come with their own uses. Your console is where you can find the ongoing logs for your server. From here, you can enter server commands such as op or ban, and the logs from the console are also used to troubleshoot any errors the server may encounter and to keep track of what is happening while it's running. This section will log and display the in-game player chat, along with displaying all of the players that are currently online. You can use this section to chat with your players too, but you'll show up as console or server in-game instead of a character name. This section will display basic information on all of the players that have ever joined the server. Entries are created as soon as a player joins in the server, or you can add a player manually. The Config Files tab allows you to quickly access most of the configuration files within a server and edit them directly. These files will vary depending on which game you're playing and if you have any plugins or mods installed for the game. You can also access these files through the FTP file access if you know where they are, but using the config section is the quickest way to get to them. The plugin list will only appear if you're running a version of Minecraft that can load plugins like paper. The plugin list is used to locate and install various plugins for your Minecraft server automatically from the Bucket or Spigot websites. The FTP page allows you to directly interact with the files on your server. From here, you can make basic changes to your server files or upload new files too. Since this tool is so powerful and can make so many changes, every time you enter, you will be asked to put in your panel password. This page is used to create and restore any backups that are available on the server. This can be beneficial for restoring progress if issues arise within a world. By default, the server will create a new backup every 24 hours, but only two backups are kept on the server at one time. This page will only appear for games that can allow custom commands. The commands page allows you to create and manage your own custom commands that can be run on your server. The panel will come pre-programmed with some very basic commands for you to use, but they can always be changed. This page allows you to create and manage automated server tasks on your server. By default, the server will come with tasks to create a backup and restart the server once a day. Users allows you to assign access to your server for other registered control panel users. This allows you to give server admins and moderators access to your console or files without having to share your own login information so that they can make changes too. With this tool, you can see any changes that you or other users have made to the server. This is beneficial for confirming a previous version, world name, or seeing what changes a specific user has made on the panel. This is one of the most useful pages in the entire control panel. The Customizations tab will include a list of functions and settings that you can change depending on the game that you're running. This is often used to change certain launch options, such as a server password, Java version, or more. Here, you can create and manage a MySQL database. These databases are used by many plugins and mods to help manage and maintain data. These are great for when you need information to be available on multiple servers. This tool allows Minecraft servers to trim the world of unused chunks. This is a good option for reducing lag and allows you to regenerate chunks. The function will delete any chunk that has not been inhabited for more than 1 second. Chunks that players have built in or that they go to frequently will always be untouched. With this tool, you can reset a variety of server files like the plugins, configs, and the jar file. This will delete files from your server and should only be used if you want to start over completely. This cannot be undone, so make sure to read through all of the prompts and windows that this tool gives you after it's been selected. A great feature for managing multiple games on your server, the Profiles tab will let you create unique profiles for each setup that you'd like to use on your panel. For example, you can have a profile for modded Minecraft, one for Rust, and one for each of the other games in our lineup that you would like to play. This makes it so you don't have to completely change your panel every time you want to host a new game. Manage Billing will send you to your billing panel once you're logged in. Here you can manage your billing account in whatever way you might need. The Knowledge Base section will quickly access a variety of video guides about managing your server. New guides are added periodically to help you better manage your server and improve your overall experience. With that, you should now have an understanding of the server management panel and each of the sections that are available for use. Whether it's to edit files, change settings, or more, the panel aims to provide simplicity and efficiency when performing any server maintenance tasks. With this understanding of the panel, you should now be able to navigate through any section you need to make the most of your Apex server. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.